Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the regular public meeting of the City of Dieppe on January 26th. Without further ado, for the prayer, God grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. We have a quorum. Are there any conflicts of interest among the councillors on any of the points, the items on the agenda tonight? None. Then we'll proceed to the adoption of the agenda, moved by Councillor. I was going to skip that when we got to the point, but we can remove from the agenda item number 10.1. So I, any motions to remove this item? Moved and seconded. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The motion is carried. The agenda is accepted as proposed with the removal of item 10.1.1. Now we'll begin with presentation of a survey done. And Mr. Richard will present the results of this community survey. Good evening, Mr. Richard. Good evening, Your Worship, councillors and residents. Our objective tonight is to present the key points of a survey that was done with the community last November by CRA Corporate Research Associates. Objectives of the survey was to collect information for our success indicators for our strategic plans. We have data that are annual or periodic. This was the last survey that was done. The one before that was 2011, and that was done in the fall. This one was done. The last one was done in the spring, and this one was done in the fall, in the beginning of the winter. Secondly, we wanted to know the opinions of the community on certain points respecting the editing of our municipal plan. We have the Imagine Dieppe initiative, and the community was part of this process. We wanted to identify priorities and issues in the community to guide us in the renewal of our strategic plan. We had a total of 400 interviews by phone. It's usual. We had 300 last year, and we had adults surveyed, all over 18 years old, and all citizens of Dieppe, people of that are less than 18 years old did not participate. We have certain figures here that are interesting. Of the 400 respondents, 53% were women and 47% men, so for a total of 210 and 190. With the categories of age, we had 18 to 34 years old, 35 to 54, and 55 and over. And you see the numbers that have participated, which reflects our community. Our main observations, it's similar to 2011. People felt that there was a feeling of belonging by the residents in the municipality, and Dieppe is perceived as a city where there is a good quality of life and a safe environment. There's also an excellent community where it's good to raise children. Other observations, we have favorable opinions and positive perspectives for the future. And there's a perception that the economy has improved during the last 3 years. However, there's a mixed opinion respecting health and community, especially the financial health. And some people are concerned by the high municipal taxes and the level of debt. Our administration will deal with that, with these high taxes. You know, we're the second lowest in big cities. People may not be aware of it, but we still have to take this information from the people. People also say that the population supports French in the neighborhood and the protection of mature trees. And a lot of people as well, a majority, say that they would change their habits for climatic change. So this is interesting. Dieppe is not always perceived as an environmental leader, and that the environment is not really an issue locally that needs a lot of attention at the time being. We talked as well about raising hens in the city, and the opinions were divided on that subject. We also spoke of road conditions and traffic, which is a concern. And people noticed that there was an improvement of the traffic in the city, but residents are still critical, concerning our road upkeeps. It's still a good place to live. Residents are privileged, and we've done a consultation with social media, and we had a new question this year. We asked people if they had a smartphone, and we saw that a lot of people did, so that could help us with our communication strategy. There's only one third of the residents that say that they've done volunteer work in 2014. And that's our indicator where we should do a lot of work. So now we have the data that we can compare with 2011. With respect to governance, there's a perception that it is open, accessible, and responsible decisions are being made, but there's a divided opinion on the efforts of the residents to participate in the decision making. There's also a preference for communication methods electronically rather than meeting people face to face, but it's not always preferable for people 55 years or older. We realize that, of course. And there is a quarter of residents that have assisted at a meeting, a council meeting, in person or on the web, on the TV in 2014. And less than one third of the people live in the center, in the downtown of Dieppe. So some people say that they live in the downtown, but the zone may not be the same as the terminology that's used elsewhere. So there's a bit of confusion there. To conclude, they say that the city of Dieppe answers to the needs of its citizens, and there is an interest for a consultation process that would be more transparent for the citizens. I could answer any questions you may have. I mentioned that this survey, this community survey, is one point that we had in our Imagine Dieppe and in our strategic plan. And for the revision of a municipal plan, and there's an evening to more night that was planned, but with the storm coming, that we've decided to put it back to Monday night. So for those who are free, we would like to ask you to come next Monday evening. So we'll repeat that. The meeting that was planned for tomorrow night on Imagine Dieppe on the 27th will take place next Monday on February 2nd, the day after the Patriots game in New England. Are there any questions? Mrs. Dadal, thank you. I don't want to show my true colors, but I don't think it's the same firm that was used to do this serving. That's it. It's another company that we used. We still had used the same questions, basically. There's a couple of questions when I read the analysis, and one of them that I saw, when you're looking at the factors of belonging to the municipality, there was an analysis done with those who were completely in agreement, or more or less in agreement. In the analysis, if you looked certain at the group that was completely in agreement, was there something, was that included? I'm not sure I understand it. Would it have been different if we had included both those groups? Well, you said that there were telephone numbers that weren't eligible, and I don't understand that. I'm not sure. I can check. Sometimes they receive certain numbers and they find out that when they call them, they're not Dieppe residents, but I can verify that. Another thing that surprised me as well, since this new mandate of the council, there's a lot of effort done to implicate citizens in municipal decisions, and I was surprised to see the answers that people gave on this particular question. People said that the best way to reach them would be electronically, and our evaluation should be done to ensure that people can participate in the process and that they be informed. And the next thing that surprised me is the age group, about my age, that feel that they're not part of this. So could you maybe do a little bit more work to so can reach that part of the population? We have a lot of work to do, and in that respect, yes, of course. Thank you, Mrs. Dadal. Councillor Thibodeau, thank you, Your Worship. I see in a few places in this survey the situation has deteriorated somewhat. Is there something that you can present to balance the situation? If I look on page 31 of our file here, it says the satisfaction with the municipal services programs. In boxes 8 to 10, there's 56%. Are we going to take initiatives to try to improve that? The management looked at the survey, and they're looking at it also. Our objective in the next few weeks is to look more deeply at these results and to see what we can move forward with. But it can also work for the priorities of the city council, and that can orient us and tell us where we can put more resources. There's a bit of a fluctuation of 4%, and it's not that important. Maybe I didn't use a good example. There could be other examples, perhaps, that are more obvious. I think the most of the time, it's pretty well balanced. 4 or 5% is good. And it says what it says. Councillor Gaudet, I recognize that when you're above the bar, and the bar is very high, that is difficult to keep our position. But what I noticed in this report and what struck me is that often there's a decrease in the quality or the number of participants or the evaluation or the positive evaluations on the subject that is being questioned. And it struck me It shocked me almost, but it angered me a little bit as well, to see on page 55 the frequency of volunteering in the community. It says 60%, and it's increasing a bit. And when you add a little bit every year, 20%, then we get to 80% of people who never do any volunteering within the community. In my opinion, that's not a very good sign. I would like to know is if management paid attention to this particularly. Is there anything that you could do? It can't stay like that. Of course, we noticed that in 2011, and again this time in 2014, with the commitment strategy within the community. You know, we've made a lot of efforts in that respect, and we can't change that from one day to the next. I think we're on the right path. Bit by bit, we're trying a step. This strategy to commit people, it takes more than municipalities. It takes a lot of organizations. And you know, we do have initiatives like the participatory budget, for instance. But it's not only in Dieppe that this is going on. It's the society in general. People are very busy, and they tell us that the organization tells us we have the same members, but they do more. Yes. We know that we have to continue, but there's still a lot of good work being done here, a lot of people that are committed to the municipality, 400 people who were surveyed, and that represents our community. Well, if you don't want to inform the rest of this survey, this one should be improved. Did you have any links between with the project of garbage collection, respecting neighbors that didn't want to cooperate with one another? They didn't want to share their environment. Have you done anything on this? The reality is that there's a lot of people that very rarely do any volunteer work or never, so they don't even know their neighbors. I can't answer for people, but I don't see the direct link to this because the citizens that we checked with who work committed to garbage removal. It was, of course, there were some streets that were against it, But I don't see the link between the two. Maybe there could be a study that could be done. But I don't see the link. I'm asking the question, is the attitude with respect to garbage collection, doesn't it show that we don't know our neighbor next door, two doors down, and we don't want to open up our horizons? And in the same train of thought, we don't want to do any volunteering. I can't answer that question. Well, all this works together. This is the fiber of the identity of the community. And I think that we would have a lot of work to do, and this would be the opportunity to work very hard on this point. I think we should put things into perspective. We have almost 20% of people who were contacted that do volunteering at least once a month. If you add up the totals, it's almost 20% of 25,000 people. So that's 5,000 people who do volunteering in the city. I'm not saying it's ideal, but it's not bad if you put things into perspective. Of course, there are analyses that should be done and come back with to council with recommendations to improve the situation and to encourage people, be it the neighborhood parties like in other areas and that type of thing. I agree that 5,000 people are out there that do a lot of work, but there are 20,000 who don't do their share as they would. They should. Well, we'll have to do some analysis and see how we can improve things. These are results that we found, and now we have to go through analysis and then a formal plan to be presented to council. I would hope so. Mrs. Dalla, I forgot to mention a point. I know the last survey was put on our website. I just want to confirm that this one will be added as well. It should be put in the same place as the other with a little bit of a summary for people so that they could compare information to see how we've progressed and to answer to comments. I know that myself, when I analyze these data, I think our energy should go towards bringing to council things that are more direct, what we can influence, and how to get the citizens to interact with us. I know volunteering is important, but we can't control that directly. We can work with organizations, yes. It's a profile, and I think we should offer possibilities to citizens to participate. Yes, sir, Your Worship. As for the website, in 2011, we had an executive summary in both official language, and we plan to do the same thing this time with a detailed report and diagrams, tables. If you want that, we'll do the same thing. But for the time being, this is an executive summary which establishes all the observations that I presented tonight. But the other one with the more details, it was about 50 pages, and we didn't put it on the website. But they're public documents. Councillor Comey, thank you, Your Worship. I have a question and a comment. I don't expect an answer, but was there a definition of volunteering when people were asked if they did volunteering? Because I think that we have hundreds of people that do volunteering, but not always in the sense that we interpret. Like people that take care of, like children, drive them here and there. Are those purpose included in these statistics? Because people may have a different interpretation of the definition of volunteering. It would be a different interpretation than ours. That's a good question. That's a good observation. Thank you, Councillor Godette. I wanted to ask who wrote the report in the format that we see it. It was CRA, Corporate Research Associates. They wrote it, they drafted it, and interpreted the data, yes. Thank you. If there are no other questions, thank you for your presentation. And now I will ask if any members of council, we have Paul Beauchel, superintendent of Kodiak, welcome again to the Dieppe Municipal Council. Thank you for the meeting that we had this afternoon to discuss eventual changes, potential changes that you're planning. And if you want to speak to the councillors on this subject, and I will ask members of council to ask questions. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I had a discussion with His Worship, with Your Worship, about the municipal councils. I wanted to be here as your police chief here at the council so that you could ask me questions. However, it's not always possible. So my suggestion to you is, you have met Jamie George that replaced Dave O'Toole, and when I'm away out of town, it will be Jamie that will replace me. And I think we should be able at all times to have Jamie or myself here before council. And I asked as well that we should arrive before the meeting starts. And if you have any questions or during the meeting, we would be here to answer them. And we would try to stay here during the whole meeting, but if there were no questions, perhaps we could leave. But if there are questions, we would always be available to answer them. You received Mr. Bocamo's presentation. It's my watch commander that he is always here. And I thought it would be a good way for Jamie and I to support all the men and women who work for the city. So in that context, that's what I proposed this evening. Are there any questions this evening for the superintendent? And we will formalize the agenda in consequence for the next meetings. If there are no questions, and I don't see any lights lit, I wish you a good evening. Thank you for being here. Thank you. I noticed that there are a few people here tonight that were wearing red. It was very appreciated. It was a hard day for people here for Kodiak. I realized you had a ceremony today to support all the members of your forces and the family of Constable David Wynne in St. Albert. Thank you. This isn't a bright red, but it's sort of red. Thank you. So we shall continue now with questions by members of the public. No questions this evening, so we will proceed to the adoption of minutes at the special council meeting held on. Mr. O'Quinn. I have a question about the survey. If I had to decide anything on this survey, I would ask questions about from other municipalities in the province to see what is done there. I don't know. Do they do this type of survey? They all do their own type of survey? Yes. Why not unite all the municipalities that want to do surveys and uniform them, go to the market? That would, we'd get a better price as well. That's a very good suggestion. Thank you, Mr. Richard made a note of that. Thank you. So we'll continue with the adoption of minutes now for a special council meeting held on December 16th. Moved by Councillor LeBlanc, seconded by Councillor Thibodeau. For the question, no questions. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. This meeting of December 16th is accepted as presented. For the regular meeting held on January 12, 2015, moved by Councillor Thibodeau, seconded by Councillor Dallaire. For the question, no questions. All those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The minutes of January 12, 2015 are accepted as presented. Now for item number 10, motions, memorandums, and nominations for engineering services. We've removed that. So we go to 10.2, leisure. With the policy L10-2015, Last week at a strategy, we have a mobile stage that we use at all events, and we rent, and it's getting a bit old, so to prolong its life, we recommend a policy for its use outside Dieppe and in the region, so we need an amendment. So there's change as well in the rates, so it's for approval by council. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Bridau. Thank you, Your Worship. The council accepts that policy L9810, entitled Rental Rates, Community Artistic Sage, adopted on August 10th, 1998, and amended on July 12th, 1999, be repealed and replaced by policy L10, brackets 2015, entitled Rental Rates, Mobile Stage. I so move. Moved by Councillor Bridau, seconded by Councillor Nguyen. On the question. We heard the two. I think it was 12, July 12. Yes. No other questions? All those in favor of this resolution signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. Now for human resources. Policy RH4, like I said a while ago, last week we presented two policies on public harassment. So this is a policy on the subject, a good frame of reference and best practices and good procedures in case we have an issue in the future. So tonight we want to adopt this resolution. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor LeBlanc. Thank you, Your Worship. The Council accepts the new policy, RH4, entitled Public Harassment Policy. I so move. Moved by Councillor LeBlanc, seconded by Councillor Dallaire. For the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. Second policy, RH5. We have a policy in place in September 2005, but there have been changes and best practices with the evolution. So this one was amended to be in conformity with the workplace policy. So we've had the recommendation last week, and this is for approval tonight to put it in place and then inform personnel when it will be adopted. For the reading of the resolution, Councillor Thibodeau. Thank you, Your Worship. The Council accepts the policy A23 entitled Harassment in the Workplace, adopted April 27th, 2009, be repealed and replaced with policy RH5 entitled Politique pour contrer le harcèlement en milieu de travail. I so move. Moved by Councillor Thibodeau and seconded by Councillor Godette on the question. Mrs. Dallaire, I just wanted to mention that there was a little mistake made that should be fixed on page 193 in our packages on the word procedures. The English version is missing the word conciliation, and in French, informal complaint of mediation, and then the sentence is not complete. We'll make that correction. Thank you for having mentioned it. Councillor Thibodeau, when we speak in this policy of mediation and arbitration, is there a procedure in place that is defined? Because in the 2009 policy, it was defined in the procedure. And here, I don't see a definition. Mrs. Savoy, effectively, yes, in effect, it was defined in our procedures. What you have before you tonight is only the policy. We have a lot of other documents with a guide, explanations, forms and other tools. So when we presented this file last week, we had all those documents. But essentially, what is being ratified tonight is only the policy. But it is well defined. Yes, thank you. If there are no other questions, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. The resolution is adopted as presented. Item number 11, municipal bylaws, 11.1. We have a third reading on bylaw C13, and this is third reading. C13, for the reading in its entirety, Mr. Brideau. Thank you, Your Worship. Bylaw number C13, 2014, a bylaw relating to the establishment of controlled access streets within the city of Dieppe. Pursuant to the authority vested in it under section 64 of the Community Planning Act, RSNB, chapter C12, the Council of the City of Dieppe duly assembled and acts as follows. Definitions in this bylaw. Committee means the Planning Advisory Committee for the City of Dieppe. Controlled access street means any street or a portion thereof listed in Schedule A. Development shall be defined as per the Community Planning Act. Access means a point of entry or exit on a street. Restricted access means an access with a raised triangular island which obstructs left turns and through movements to and from the intersecting street or driveway situated in the proximity of a medium strip existing on the street. Temporary access means an access permitted on a street for a fixed period not exceeding a maximum period of 1 year. Street means any public street located within the city of Dieppe. Utility includes any person or corporation that provides water, electric power, telecommunications service, natural gas, or other gas intended for use as fuel to the public. 2, prohibited activity on controlled access streets. 1, no person shall construct, use, open, or permit the use of any access to any part of a street designated as a controlled access street. 2, notwithstanding the provisions of subsection 2, brackets 1, no new access shall be permitted onto a controlled access street unless it is separated by at least 200 meters from its center line to the center line of another street or access. 3, any development on a property abutting a controlled access street is prohibited if, in the opinion of the committee, it would interfere in any way with the use of such controlled access street. 3, exceptions. 1, this bylaw shall not apply to A, municipally owned properties, B, an access for utility, C, an emergency access. D, a restricted access approved by the Planning and Development Department and the Engineering Department. E, a temporary access approved by the Engineering Department. And F, an access existing prior to the date of adoption of this bylaw. Repeal. I read that as well. Bylaw C-13, entitled a bylaw relating to the establishment of controlled access streets within the city of Dieppe, adopted November 26, 2012, and filed in the Westmoreland County Registry Office under number 32246283 on December 7, 2012, is repealed. Schedule A. Access prohibited. Street name, Dieppe Boulevard, the entire length. Thank you. That's it. Thank you. For the resolution, seconded by Councillor Delaire. On the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye, contrary minded, nay. The bylaw C-13 is accepted by reading in its entirety, so we'll start third reading by title only. Councillor Bridau. Bylaw number C-13, brackets 2014, a bylaw relating to the establishment of controlled access streets within the city of Dieppe. I so move. By title only, third and final reading. Moved by Councillor Bridau, seconded by Councillor Delaire. If there are no questions, all those in favor signify by saying aye, contrary minded, nay. Bylaw number C-13 is accepted in third reading. Bylaw C-13. Now for bylaw number Z-11 in its entirety, but by title only, since it was published in the media. Councillor LeBlanc. Thank you, Your Worship. Bylaw number Z11, brackets 2014, building bylaw. In its entirety, 1, definitions. 2, adoption of code. 3, prohibitions. 4, exemptions. 5, permit application process. 6, special requirements. 7, issuance of permit. 8, revocation of permit. 9, responsibility of permit holder. 10, electrical waiver. 11, tests. 12, schedule of fees. 13, offenses. Repeal bylaw number Z11, entitled Building Bylaw, adopted May 27, 2013, and filed in the Westmoreland County Register Office on May 29, 2013, under number 32712136, is repealed. I so move in second reading in its entirety. Thank you for this reading. Now, for seconder, Councillor Nolan. All those in favor signify by saying aye. If there are no questions, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. Bylaw number Z11 is accepted by reading in its entirety. We will proceed a third reading by title. Bylaw number Z11, building bylaw. I so move by third reading and it's by title. Councillor LeBlanc, seconded by Councillor Nolan. For the question, all those in favor signify by saying aye. Contrary minded, nay. Bylaw number Z11 is accepted in third reading, third and last reading. Thank you. Now, item number 10, notice of motion. Are there any notices of motions? No. Now for inquiries and announcement by members of council. We shall start with Councillor Thibodeau. I have nothing for this evening, Your Worship. Thank you. Thank you, Councillor Cormier. Thank you, Your Worship. I wish a good carnival to everyone on the weekend. Thank you. We hope everybody will be very active. We were wishing for good weather. Councillor Godette. Yes, I was happy to see, even though I did mention a while ago, the correlation that we established on the questions that we asked in 2011 and 2014. Concerning the study that we saw a little while ago, it's interesting to see these questions that allow us to make valuable comparisons. I see that no one from engineering or public works are mentioned. Is this a new formula? Is there any reason why they're not here tonight? They had to leave at the end of the afternoon, but if there are any questions, I will follow up with the divisions, because in the report, we mentioned the streets and public works on the designated highways. We're working hard on future projects. Let it console me a little bit, Your Worship. I would like to mention that assistance participated was 100%. Thank you, Mr. Reginald, to have saved the honor of the citizens of Dieppe tonight. Councillor Dallaire, it's one that's hard to follow. I have nothing to mention this evening. Thank you. Councillor Nolan, thank you, Your Worship. I just wanted to say, I wanted to wish citizens a very good snow day tomorrow, very safe day with all the snow and the wind that we're expecting. And I think I'm speaking for all members of council that we're all thinking of Mr. Constable Wind, who was killed in Alberta. And it reminds us of what we went through in June. And this is very sad. Thank you. Councillor Rideau. Councillor Jordan said exactly what I was going to say. I'll just add a detail. Waiting for this storm tomorrow, I would ask people to be patient when we're removing snow from the streets. Sometimes it's not happening quickly enough for some people, but you have to give the workers a chance to get it all done. Thank you, Councillor LeBlanc. Thank you, Your Worship. same thing. I wanted to repeat what Councillor Nolan said. I think we should all take a moment in our time for our police forces who fight day in and day out to protect us. And I think we should keep these people in our thoughts. Thank you. Without further ado, I wish a good evening to everyone and our colleague, Councillor Béliveau, gonna be with us. Good evening to everyone.